During this time, he wanted to establish an ideal Islamic university by the name of Madrasa Zahra in mindfulness, but due to Ottoman Empire's involvement in the First World War, his dream project outside Nursi could not be realized. He participated in war and arrest by the Allied forces and later kept in Siberia as a prisoner of war, where he spent 2 years in jail. It is interesting to know that when the Russian commander of Nursi came, everybody stood up in his honor except Sir Nursi. When he was asked for the reason, he told the Russian that my religion did not allow me to stand up for a company of the town. Finally, he was ordered to be executed. When he was asked for his last wish, he told he should be allowed to offer poor Gatamas for his execution. Russian army officer was so much impressed by this strong belief in Almighty God, moral courage and determination that he cancelled his execution order. He escaped from jail in 1918 and reached Istanbul, where he was appointed to the Dawud-e-Millet İslamiye, and he started his public life there. In 1923, when the new government came to power in Turkey under the leadership of Mustafa Kemal, he was offered many posts in the newly set up Republican government, but he did not accept. The only reason was that his views and thoughts were not in conformity with Mustafa Kemal and his colleagues. He empirically criticized the process of modernization and reforms in Turkey. That's why he was assigned to Western Mongolia and finally to Balkan and Sparta province, where he spent 25 years of his life. In 1925, he started writing his magnum opus collection, the Risale-i, and completed in 1933. It took him 8 years to finalize this. This was the most important period of his life. Despite of constant surveillance and hardship, he continued his work. He had been in exile until 1915. In life span of 25 years, he had been prosecuted in prison by the state due to his opposition of government on several issues. He says, "During my life of over 80 years, I am tested no more in prison. Either I have spent my life in mental fields or in prisons or in exile. They have treated me like a criminal, banishing me from one job to another, keeping me under constant surveillance. There has been no prosecution I have not visited, no oppression I have not suffered." He suffered a lot, but he did not go down to the despotic rulers of modern Turkey. He opposed the reform agenda, he struggled to protect Islamic identity of Turkish people, and expressed his dissent of many efforts to sabotage this vicious identity peacefully. In 1950, when the Democratic Party came to power, said Nursi was a teacher. Since then, his famous Risale-i had become very popular in the Islam of Turkey. This great Islamic scholar thinking of that in Nursi under the time of 1960, leaving behind his thought-provoking collection of Risale-i, so that mankind could get enlightened from his book in and outside Turkey. Educational thoughts of Sayyid Nursi. If someone studies Risale-i, he will find that Nursi has very much emphasized the faith in God and seeking knowledge. He completely refused to accept separation between religious and material sciences. He wanted to integrate the knowledge with faith as fully. Without having faith in Almighty God, human being cannot be placed, and without having knowledge, life will have no meaning. So both faith in Almighty God and seeking a perfect knowledge are necessary to make human life meaningful. Sayyid Nursi has discussed several issues related to education in his famous Risale. I have chosen 2 issues of his best concern to deal with. First, his views on religious education system, and the second part was his approach to reconcile between religious and modern education. Sayyid Nursi was one of the great Muslim scholars and thinkers who felt that the existing religious education system in Turkey was a complete failure, because it was not fulfilling the needs of Muslim people that is required to be reformed. He was not satisfied with the quality of education being provided by the then religious education system. He himself, having studied at Madrasa, knew very well the flaws of Madrasa, slavery He regarded that it was no longer relevant to honor judgment in the favor of sciences. The ulama who were produced at this madrasa, most of them were believed to be unaware of modern sciences, and that's why they would see the contradiction between some of Islamic matters and modern sciences. So according to Sayyid Nursi, who studied at madrasa were not familiar with the modern sciences, and those who studied at secular educational system were not familiar with the modern sciences.